I'm Kiera Morgan. Thanks for joining me on Coffee with Kiera, sponsored by The Human Being in Newport and in Lincoln City. And today I'm excited to be talking with my dear friend, Todd Williver, who is Lincoln County 4-H Coordinator. Hi, Todd.
Hello, Kiera. How are you?
A long time no see. It's good to see you again.
My gosh, it seems like 2 years since we did this.
I know. Well, I'm so excited because we are going to be having a fair once again in Lincoln County. Last year, that was a tough call to make, wasn't it?
Yeah, well, you know, it was sort of made for us. It just wasn't possible to pull the event together with all of the unknowns that the state and the feds were throwing at us. It was tough not to do it. The call itself, as I said, really wasn't our call. We just simply couldn't pull it off.
But throughout all of this pandemic, has 4-H been able to continue doing something even remotely with the kids?
Yeah, you know, we've been doing some virtual programming. Of course, it's hard to raise a steer or a pig virtually, but but there are other things that our kids are doing, photography contests and quiz bowls, knowledge bowls, all sorts of different things. It's been a tough year on 4-H kids. I think we all know that it's just been a tough year on kids, period. Trying to figure out how to go to school virtually and being isolated socially from their networks and their friends, their peers. It's been a tough road across the board, but I think the 4-H kids generally are doing okay. And of course, chomping at the bit to emerge from this COVID thing and get back to, some semblance of normalcy.
So let's talk a little bit about what Lincoln County Fair is going to look like this year. Are there some adjustments that you've had to make?
Yeah, well, the crazy thing is we don't really know yet. the way the county health department and the state keep throwing, it's just been in the last 14 days, right, that the mask mandate has been lifted. So we don't know what to expect in the next 5 weeks. What I'm telling people is that we're planning for a fair as usual. And as we get to the show, we will make whatever adjustments are necessary.
So let's talk a little bit about what you have planned for this year's fair.
Yeah, it's been a bit of a tough year. A lot of vendors have gone out of business during this COVID season, and or they're not back up and fully running yet. They've sort of shut down and haven't made the adjustment to be back up and running. The short answer, Kiera, I think it's going to be a show that's pretty much like it has been over the past years. We've got a fairly full food court, a reasonably full main exhibit hall, several outside vendors, and the NPRA fully sanctioned pro rodeo. So all of those are good things. Things that we're working on right now, trying to get bouncy houses. That's one of the businesses that always supported us. But of course, Yo-Ho-Ho Bounce had to shut down during COVID, and we're trying to figure out how to make that work. There's a possibility. Here's a little teaser. We every year we say this, I think, and it never happens, but I think there's a possibility we'll have some sort of a carnival. We're working on it. The door hasn't been slammed in our face. It turns out that there are so few fairs running that the carnivals really want to get back to work. And so we're just trying to figure out the pricing of it to see if it's economically feasible. We do have the American Thunder Monster Truck coming back on Friday that will give free rides to kids all day long on Friday. So stay tuned for that. If you want to get a picture of your kid in a monster truck, he'll be tearing up that arena and making all sorts of dust Friday during the day. And then of course we'll have the pro rodeo starting on Saturday and Sunday. So again, I guess to answer your question, that was sort of a long-winded way to do it. I think it's going to be pretty much, I hope it's going to be pretty much what we've done in the past. It may be a little diminished in some areas only because vendor participation has been tough. You know, COVID's been tough on vendors across the board. But other than that, I think it'll be pretty much the fair as we know it, I'm sure hoping.
So what does entertainment look like this year?
Full lineup. We've one of the things that we chose to do is to only do local music this year. We didn't go out of the local area regionally or out of the state. We know that our artists, our local musicians have not been able to play for 16 months and they're starving. So to honor that, we only spent money on local artists this year. And we've got Steve Mason has a full slate from Friday morning to till Sunday afternoon at close. We're going to have music.
That's awesome. Oh, live music and concerts again. I can't wait.
Yeah. Hey, another thing that I think it's safe to announce, Saturday after the rodeo. So it'll be somewhere around 7-8 o'clock at night. We're going to do our first ever dance in the dirt. We've got a good country band, a local band that's going to light it up there in the arena. And we're all going to get our boots dirty dancing in the arena Saturday night. So instead of an act performing on the main stage, we'll all be down there in the arena getting dirty.
That sounds like fun. Count me in.
All right.
And let's talk a little bit about the rodeo itself.
Yeah, so we're really excited to have the NPRA Pro Rodeo back again. This will be our second year with just 1 year of a hiatus due to COVID. For anybody that didn't see it in 2019, oh my gosh, we were with our freshman effort back in the rodeo scene. We were the fourth largest NPRA rodeo in the state. And in fact, that transcends states. Northwest Pro Rodeo Association covers Oregon, Washington, and even a little bit of Idaho. So we were the fourth largest rodeo in our very, very first event. If for people that were there Saturday night to see that just sea of horse trailers, we didn't have an open parking spot on that entire fairgrounds. Horse trailers just stacked in everywhere. It was quite amazing. We had a great rodeo. It was a great show. Nobody got hurt. Hopefully that'll hold true again this year. Just a really great event. We're excited to have it back again. It is a full rodeo, so all of the
rest. That was going to be my next question. Is it bull riding, barrel racing, everything that it was before?
Yep, the whole shebang. We moved away from just the bull riding event in 2018, and have done committed to do a full rodeo that includes all eight rodeo events. So we'll see the calf ropers, we'll see the steer wrestlers, we'll see the saddle bronc and bareback riders, we'll see the bull riders, we'll see the barrel racers. They're all going to be there. In fact, it includes breakaway roping, which is the women's second women's event to barrel racing, where they rope a steer, but then just let it go out the arena. It's called breakaway roping. So two events for the ladies, and then all of the men's events, of course.
And of course, the rodeo is, as you mentioned, a sanctioned rodeo. They take very good care of their animals, right?
Yeah, absolutely. The you know, rodeo animals are working animals, just like cattle dogs or whatever type of animal partners with humans to get work done. And obviously these stock contractors couldn't make it if they put their animals in jeopardy. A 125 pound cowboy on the back of a 2000 pound bull is not a real detriment to the bull. Usually the bull comes out of that one just fine. So oftentimes we do have a vet on hand and the stock contractor takes great care of their animals, but oftentimes it's the cowboys that we worry about, not jeopardizing the animals.
All right. And how much is the fair going to cost folks to get in this year, Todd?
So the fair, as always, since we took over in 2014, is absolutely free. Our philosophy is this event belongs to the people. It's not a money-making effort. If I can break even and continue doing it, I'm happy to do it. The county likes it. The county supports it for the as an event for the public. So it's absolutely free of charge. The exception is we do charge on occasion for special events. So we've had some music in the past that we've charged a gate fee for, and we do charge for the rodeo. The rodeo is so doggone expensive that we have to charge a gate fee to make ends meet. If I could do it for free, I certainly would. And with sponsorship, maybe someday that can happen. But at this point, we do charge a nominal ticket price, $15 for anybody over 10 years of age, free for kids under 5, free for seniors over 80, and free for veterans. But we do have to generate a little revenue to make ends meet on a really expensive production like that.
All right. And Todd, where can folks go if they want to get some more information?
Yeah. So the LincolnCountyFair.com is our website. You have to get the in front of there. It turns out there are a whole bunch of Lincoln counties and Lincoln County fairs out there, but ours is the Lincoln County Fair. That's the website where you can find everything. Rodeo tickets will be available at ticketleap.com. One word, ticketleap.com. And then you just search by either city, Newport, or event name, Lincoln County Fair, and you'll be able to find those rodeo tickets. Fair warning, it will be limited seating. So buy now, because when we start getting close to what we think the state and or the county will let us have in the arena there, we're gonna just shut it off without notice. So limited seating by soon.
All right, wonderful. Well, Todd, thank you so much for joining me on Coffee with Kiera, sponsored by the Human Bean in Newport and Lincoln City. In Newport at 6th Street and Highway 101, and in Lincoln City at the north end of town on the west side of the highway next to TLC Credit Union. For Pacific Northwest News and Entertainment, I'm Kiera Morgan.